Let's look at traditional radiation patterns for high-gain, patch array sector antennas in a 3D view. What you'll notice is there are three typical parts of this pattern. You have your main lobe, where your ideal connectivity comes from, and then you have front and back or side lobes. Let's look at a more simplified 2D view that is normally found in spec sheets and WISPs are used to reading. When we look at typical radiation patterns, we usually think of them in one way, only the measured gain of the main lobe in relation to your CPE's distance. What we usually ignore is the distance that your AP signal will travel past your coverage area and then become noise for your radios as well as others. Also, another important part that is often overlooked is the effect of the side lobe radiation pattern and the effective distance of this signal as noise and, more important, for receiving noise. Most users think side lobes only affect co-located APs, but they are a huge receptor of noise from much greater distances than one might think. Now let's look at how introducing high-power radios in combination with these high-gain antennas really reduce the spectrum efficiency of your radiating station and creates more noise for you. You can see when we turn up TX power, your coverage area grows, as well as the total signal propagation as noise. Now let's look at our lower-gain symmetrical horn antennas with no side lobes. You can clearly see how it's capable of rejecting noise by acting as a natural filter. If we compare them side by side, you can see how you are able to achieve similar distances with more TX power, but dramatically reducing received noise by having lower receive gain and no side lobes. It's clear how much more noise rejection a horn antenna has than a traditional sector when we overlap them. The effective area of sending noise and also receiving it is dramatic. In conclusion, more forward antenna gain is not always the answer. High-gain antennas create more problems with side lobes and make it harder for you to manage your available spectrum, which we know is getting more and more crowded every day.